And we are fading LEDs.
Hello, and in this video I am going to be covering how to use the PWM module. First, let's go over the hardware connection. As per usual, I have my LEDs connected to port B and then RC1 as my PWM output on CCP2. Now the LEDs are connected to transistors and then multiplexed to the single PWM pin. Let's have a look at the datasheet. Now the first register we need to go over for the PWM is timer 2. This is used to determine the timings of the PWM. The postscaler we are not going to use, but we're going to set it anyways to a 1-to-1. Then timer on we're just going to use to start the PWM. Timer prescaler is going to be used to determine the clock frequency of the timer, and I'm going to use it as a 1-to-1 as well. And let's have a look at the block diagram. Then in the block diagram we have our prescaler, then timer 2, and then a comparator. And then the comparator goes straight to the PWM module. So it bypasses the postscaler, that is why we are not using it. And let's have a look at the PWM module. In this PIC we're going to use CCP2Con, as CCP1 is implemented as an enhanced module on the 40-pin and 44-pin devices, as this is a 40-pin device. Now, in the register, we have 7 and 6 as unimplemented, and then our least significant bits to control the duty cycle of the PWM is located in bit 5 and 4. And then the most significant bit is in the CCPR2L register. And then in our CCP2 mode select, we are going to select PWM mode. And now in the PWM, we have to configure the CCP2 pin as a output, and then it is multiplexed in the configuration bits to port C, RC1. Our PWM period is done by writing to the PR2 register, and this is the formula for calculating the PWM period in time scale, in seconds. In just 1 over the PWM period, we get the frequency. I'm going to target for a 100 kHz frequency. And the PWM duty cycle is calculated using this formula. Now back to the PWM period, the value we are going to require here is PR2, since all other values are known. Let me refer to my paint. This is the formula described in the datasheet. This is the manipulated, and we get a value of 19 for PR. At a PWM frequency of 100 kHz, with an oscillator frequency over here at 8 MHz, and then the prescaler set to a 1-to-1. Now let's get to coding. A quick summary of what's in the code. The oscillator is set to 8 MHz. TRISC-B is set as output. Then the entire B port is driven high to switch on the transistors. Now the first thing we want to do is set the CCP pin on RC1 as output. So TRISC-C bits, member RC1 equals to 0. Next, what we do is we set up timer 2. So we say T2Con bits member T2Out PS equals to 0 to set the postscaler as a 1-to-1. Then we set the prescaler bits. So we copy T2Con bits and we say T2CKPS is equals to 0 to set the prescaler as a 1-to-1. So we start with the PR2 register. PR2 is equals to 19 that we calculated earlier. Then we add in CCP2Con bit, member DC2B is equals to 0, and then copy CCPCon2 and we say CCP2Mode is equals to 0xC0. To set it in PWM mode. Now, a register I didn't cover in the datasheet is CCPR2L equals to 0. Now, this is your most significant bits for the duty cycle. Then we end off the configuration by enabling timer 2, copy paste the TCON2 bits. Then we say TMR2On equals to 1. And that's the configuration for the PWM. Next, we go to the top and we add a function of type void. We call it PWM score set, pass it a value of uint 16, and we call it duty. Now, next, what we do is we copy the least significant bits of the duty cycle, paste it here, we typecast it to uint 8, and we say duty and 0x0003 to parse out the two least significant bits of the duty cycle. And then next, we copy the most significant bits. We say that's equals to typecast uint 8, and it's duty left shift by 2. Now for the demonstration code, I am going to fade some LEDs. So I'm going to add two variables of uint 16, PWM count equals to 0, and uint 16, PWM mode equals to 0. Now PWM count will be the duty cycle, and PWM mode will be either upcounting or downcounting. But first, let's just demonstrate upcounting. First, we add in PWM set and the variable PWM count passed to it. And after PWM set, we increment PWM count. And if PWM count is greater or equals to 0x03FF, which is the maximum of a 10-bit register, PWM count is reset to 0. Then we add a delay of 25 milliseconds between each count, just so we can see the LEDs fading. We program the PIC. So I found a mistake. The PWM mode should be 0C and not C0. And I'm going to adjust the reset to 4F. Otherwise, the PIC takes too long to reset the values. Now we program the PIC. Now, as you can see, the LEDs fade in on the upcounting and then reset to 0. Also, judging by the voltmeter showing that the voltage increases. Now, next, what I'm going to add in is a fade in and out. So at max brightness, fade down, and at min brightness, fade in. Now, to implement the fade in and out, we change PWM count to PWM mode equals to 1 in our if statement. And we add if PWM count is equivalent to 0, PWM mode equals 0. And we say if PWM mode is equivalent to 0, increment the PWM counter. And above set PWM, we add an if PWM mode is equivalent to 1, decrement the counter. Now we program the PIC. As you can see, the LEDs are fading in and out. And that's a basic introduction of using the PWM module on a PIC. Any parts that I've used will be linked down in the description. Any code that I've written will be uploaded to my Git. A like, share, comment, and subscription would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.